Okay, my name is Nabokonato. I'm from Jimba University Department of Physics. I wanted to present on the title of the effect of agent of particle motion and the evolution of host galaxy. When we see the outline of this work, one background in literature review, the statement of problem, objectives, meteorology, introduction of GR, particle motion, radiative transport, radiative transfer, result and discussion, summary and conclusion. When we see the background in literature review, AGNR or active galactic nuclei are the compact core of special category of galaxies that are characterized by high luminosity of non-stellar origin. They are the most luminous persistent sources of the universe. Their luminosity comes from the central region of the galaxy, and the engine of this activity is supermassive black hole in the center of the host galaxy. The radiations come from the central regions of active galactic supermassive black hole at the center of mass, having the mass from 10 to the power of 6 to 10 to the power of 9 solar mass. The first recurring observational evidence for the existence of AGN came from Edwards. Edwards obtained the star cluster, and the Seyfert studied about the Seyfert galaxies with the nuclear emission lines. Furthermore, the development of radio astronomy and the quasars were the key initiative in understanding of AGN. Collectively, the powerful radio sources, quasars, and the Seyfert galaxies are now called AGN because of their luminosity. On the other hand, the energy deposited by AGN on its environment is thought to be fundamentally influenced its host galaxy. However, the detail on the mechanism allowing nuclear activity to play a significant role on the formation and evolution of host galaxies remained elusive. The less steady feeding process of supermassive black hole precedes the feedback process, and they play a fundamental role not only in supermassive black hole evolution, but also in the evolution of host galaxies. Even though the global picture of AGN are fully understood, but the detail of AGN physics are still fully constrained. So motivated by this scientific rationale, we are interested to study the effect of AGN on particle motion and on evolution of host galaxies using Kerr-Newman metric. When we see the statement of problem, under that we see the research questions. What are the geodetic equations of the motion near the central black hole of AGN? Two, in what way does AGN affect the motion of the nearby particles? Three, how does AGN affect the evolution of the host galaxy? Four, what is the source of high luminosity of AGN? When we see the objective of this work, general objectives, to study the effect of AGN on particle motions and evolution of host galaxy, the specific objective of this work is one, to derive the equation of motion of particles in the vicinity of AGN central black holes. Two, to describe the effect of AGN on particle motion. Three, to explain the effect of AGN on the evolution of host galaxy. Four, to determine the source of luminosity of AGN. When we see the methodology of this work, the central engine of AGN is considered with charging and spinning supermassive black holes. So we use the Kerr-Newman metric with the general generalistic equations. Using Einstein general relativity for field equation, we derive the Euler-Lagrange equation. So the Euler-Lagrange equations are used. Then the Euler-Lagrange equations are used to derive the effective potentials, and to that effective potential are used to characterize the orbit of particles. relative radiative transfer equations are used to characterize the mass energy phenomena from the black holes and characterize the energy, the feedback energy, feedback agent, agent feedback. So the Euler language equations are considered. The other thing is the equations of mass are considered. That is characterized by Eddington luminosity limit. For analysis of the result, mathematical element software is used for plot. LaTeX is used for documentation purpose. When we see the introduction of GR, the exact solution of Einstein field equation are give the unique survey for known solution of Einstein field equation for a vacuum. So we will consider the Einstein solution for a vacuum to have this one, the KM1 metric. So the KM1 metric are given by these equations. When we see the unified model of AGN, in this case, the central region is supermassive black holes. Actually, the unified model of AGN depend on the size of observer, whether the central region is observed directly or obscured by the mediums. But the AGN are divided into two, actually depend on their luminosity. Radio part AGN and radio large GN. In the case of radio part AGN, we have severed galaxy as well as severed galaxy 1, severed galaxy 2, as well as the radio part galaxies. In the case of radio large AGN, we have the low power and high power radio loud quasar, radio loud. In the case of radio low power, we have Fanaroff relay 1 and the Fanaroff brothers. In the high power, we have Fanaroff relay 2. This is the unified model of AGN. When we see the relativistic equation of motion of the particle in the Kerr-Newman geometry, here to have this one, we extremize the invariant geodesic element of the particle, which is given by equation 2. From this one, we have the Euler language equations, which is given by this equation 3. So, setting theta pi over 2 at the quadraplane or in the Kerr-Newman metric, we obtain this one, the Lagrange part, by making theta is equal to pi over 2. That means theta dot is equal to 0. So we don't have the theta part here. So since the space-time of the Kerr-Newman metric is partly stationary and axially symmetric, the momentum pt and the p are conserved. So we have this equation 5 and 6. So solving for E is energy and the momentum is given by this one. So from the equation 7 and 8, we can get the corresponding velocity, P dot and the phi dot. When we see the radiative transfer, radiative transfer is the physical phenomenon of energy transfer in the form of electromagnetic radiations. It is stating how the radiation is propagated through the medium. So the propagation of the medium through the radiations through the medium is affected by observations, emission, and scattering processes. The expressions of the variation in the path length with respect to affine parameter of massless particles is given by equation 9. So from this one, the presence of the mass modifies the particle equation from time-like to the null-like to time-like. So for the massive particle, we have these equations. This is abrasion factors. When m is 10 to 0, we have the same equation with equation 9. This is the emission part, this is the absorption part. There is abrasion factor, which is given by 1 minus mu over energy, the whole square root under the square root. When we see the result and the discussion, the boundary horizon and the singularities. In the case of Kerr-Newman space-time, whose method is given by equation 1 in the first, that we have seen in the last presentation, the geometrical boundaries are through singularity, the static limit of Kerr-Newman method and the horizon solution. True singularity is a removable singularity or pseudometric, so which is given by rho squared is equal to 0, which is at r is equal to 0 and theta is equal to pi over 2. Event horizons, it is a coordinate dependent singularity, which is given when delta is equal to 0. So under that we get this one. R plus event horizons and r minus is inter-side of horizons of black holes. Okay. When we see the static limit of the Kerr-Newman metric when GTT is equal to 0, which is given by this one, this is ergosphere, inner ergosphere and outer ergosphere is there. When R plus is, which is m plus or under square root of m square minus alpha square or spin parameter cosine square theta minus q square, when it's plus, it is outer ergosphere, when it's minus, inner ergosphere. So the orbital motions and the Kerr-Newman metric, employing the Euler-Lagrange equation of two extrema of the metric, we obtain the constant of motion like energy, angular momentum, and the Carter constants. So from equation 7 and 8, we have the t component in this one, t dot, pi dot is this one. The radial equation, along the radial, we have the following equations. This one, this is the radial equations. So considering the particle mass of m, which is much less than m, exhibit a circular orbit within the condition used in quadrant plane when theta is equal to, as we consider as we assume in theta is equal to pi over 2, that means theta dot is equal to 0 and r dot and r double dot is 0. Then the natural frequency of the natural frequency is given by this one. So the angular frequency decreases as spin parameters or spin parameter as well as the charge is increases from this one. So following the effective potential derivation of the well-known Schwarzschild geometry of this one, LPS2, construct the equation of effective potential in the presence of the charge. Because Schwarzschild geometry have no charge, so when charge and spin parameter is considered, we have this effective potential. In the pure Schwarzschild space-time, the potential is always attractor for photons, for masses. However, in the Kerr-Newman space-time geometry, depending on the parameters of the underlying black hole, that parameters are spin parameters as well as the charge parameters. The effect of Kerr-Newman geometry on geodesy, we see the frame dragging, like example. Frame dragging is the effect of space-time that is due to non-static stationary distribution of mass energy. It is a generalistic feature of all solutions to the instant field equations associated with rotating mass. So from the Lagrange, we have the following equation, this part. Momentum T and the momentum pi. From that, solving equation 8 and 9, the last equations. For T and pi, we have the angular velocity of frame dragging, which is given by equation 20. By making G angular momentum 0, we have Zamo, which is minus gt phi e over g phi e, which is the zero angular momentum observers. So now substituting equation 7 and 8 into equation 20, we have the following angular velocity frame dragging, which is given by this one. This equation is the angular velocity of frame dragging of Kerr-Newman spacetime for equatorial plane. So the general expression for angular velocity of frame dragging, which is for a charged rotating body with a radius r, in Kerr-Newman geometry is given by this one. By making Q zero, we have the frame dragging of the angular frame dragging of the Kerr metric. By making Q is equal to zero, we have the static limits for speed parameter is equal to zero. We have a Reissner no restraint, the Kerr-Newman angular velocity. When you see the accretion as the main source of energy released from the astronomical object, the matter falling into the black hole heats up and emits radiations. That's the accretions. The source of energy released are stellar evolution and the accretions. Then the total energy radiated by per unit area, per unit time is given by this one. This is from the accretion part. This is from the gravitational energy. So from this one is the dominating one. So in general, for the gravitating system, the source of the energy released from the surface is dominated by gravitational due to accretion and the nuclear reactions. This one is the dominating one. The energy released from the accretion, nuclear process, and other energy released from the rises due to geometry and the thermodynamic effect as considered as an active galactic nuclei paper. This is the horizon solution of Kerr-Newman metric by making R plus and R horizons and the ergosphere, making dimensionless. This one is outer ergosphere, this part. This one is inner horizons. That one is the inner horizons. The central one is the inner ergosphere, which is, this is the horizon solution of Kerr-Newman metric. Okay, this is a plot of general effective potential for the Kerr-Newman metric. This one, the dashed black one is the Kerr-Newman metric when mass, speed parameter and the charge are considered. The magenta one is the Kerr metric, and the blue one is the Reissner non-restraint metric, and the blue one, the orange one is the Schwarzschild spacetime. This is the effective potential for Kerr-Newman geometry. Okay, once back. When we see the potential, the orbit characteristics at any point, or the bottom one, at the bottom, there is a circular orbit at that point and the star. Where do we see that? The tip of this one, at the tip, yeah. No other, okay. When we see at the tip, the effective potential, the derivative of effective potential with respect to dr, with respect to the distance is zero. At that point, when the teeny perturbation inward is there, the particle are fell down into the hole. When the teeny perturbations is there on outward, the particle is kicked up to the infinity. This is effective potential for this one is for massless particles like photons, and this one is the effective potential for massive particles. When you see the conclusion of the, this work, in general, AGN are among the important astrological systems used, being used in astrophysical studies that require diverse area of physics from quantum to high energy physics. In order to study, we have covered the geometric effects of the AGN that arise from gravity, spin and the charge. Our analytical study covered derivations and analysis of the equation of motions, particles, orbit characterization with aid of central effect potential of AGN determined by underlying supermass black holes. The AGN back feedback effective both from geometry and accretion process that have been covered in our study. Finally, the astrophysical nature of AGN and its effect are on the nearby environment it is host and the distant objects are still fresh and active that needs to further research. Thank you.